Hello, ladies! How are you? I hope you're doing good. I put a little purple in my hair last night.
I think it looks fabulous.
Just for fun.
Beautiful. It's
supposed to wash out in 12 washes.
Oh, no, but I love it. I think you should keep it forever. And it matches your lipstick as well.
How can I get it to stay for longer? I don't know.
You have to keep putting it in.
Well, there's that.
Yeah. You know, upkeep. That's us women. We have to do maintenance.
Yeah,
that's
well, I figured 12 washes was a good way to start in case you didn't like it, but I'm into it.
I'm totally loving it, though. And I love it with the lipstick. And you've got it all going. Perfection. Love it.
You're
nail on the head.
Okay, ladies. Gabriella, Rebecca, hey, how are you? Hey, Renata. Hey, Monique. So good to see you. Hey, Corey. Okay. I've got Angie here with me today.
Nice to meet you.
And I'm so excited to introduce you to her. Before we got off on my purple hair, I just want to tell you a little bit about her. Now, so you guys, you know how I love the topic of empowering women. I love women business owners, all those things. So I run a boudoir studio here where I take pictures of Victoria's Secret style photo experience for the everyday woman. And what I also like to do is meet and promote other female business owners and people who are empowering women in lots of different ways. So I've got Angie here today to talk about what she does. And if you have any questions, jump into the comments, chatter up. She's an open book.
Completely open book, ask me anything.
Yeah, so I'm just gonna let her introduce herself, tell you a little bit about what she does. And I'm really excited to have her. So take it away, Angie, tell us what you do.
I'm so excited to be here. Thank you so much, Liz, for having me. I really appreciate this. I love empowering women. It is my passion. It is my thing, 1,000%. So short story, I'm a local mom. I have 6 children. I was widowed almost 8 years ago. And when that happened to me, when life kind of knocked me down, I thought to myself, you know what? You gotta get back up. You've gotta put one foot in front of the other, and you've got to show your children and you've got to show yourself, prove to myself that you are strong. Just because life knocked you down, just because there was a bump in the road, doesn't mean you have to stay down there. I say to people all the time, it's not about the falling down, it's about the how long you stay down there for. So I was mentally psyching myself up and I said, you know what, I've got to do something that I've never done before in my entire life, something so strong and something so incredibly powerful that I proved to myself and I proved to my children that we can do this no matter what. Even though life has knocked us down and it was a super terrible, awful, no good, very bad, traumatic event in all of our lives. But I said, you know what, guys? I said to my 6 babies, we're still here. We've got to keep on going and we've got to fight the fight, right? We're not going to let life defeat us. So with that in mind, I said, you know what? I'm going to take up boxing.
Like you do.
Like you do. Like what every suburban typical mom does. I'm just going to take up boxing, right? Wasn't even
hey,
ever
ladies,
heard of.
Are any of you involved with boxing? If you are, raise your hand. We need to hear from you.
Boxers in the house. Is there any boxers in the
house? Or have
you
ever even done kickboxing? We want to hear.
Anything.
We want to hear any level of boxing. We want to know. Have you ever watched boxing?
Watched boxing. No, any. It's like, you know what?
Do you know anyone who boxes?
The only
hey, we're getting some hearts.
There we go.
Who's
yay!
A boxer on here? We want to hear from you. This is so good, Angie. Okay.
So nice. So the only boxer I ever knew was Sylvester Stallone, Rocky, who's not an actual boxer. I will point that out, but he's so fabulous.
He's not? Right? He's not. Wait, you're shattering my world.
I know.
Right? Wait, so
that's how I felt as well.
Tell me more about that. He just trained for the movie.
He just trained for the movie. I think he does it in his personal life, but he's not a professional boxer.
Okay, fair.
Fair.
He's an actor.
He's an amazing actor. And
is his boxing bad in those movies?
Oh, his boxing's very good.
Oh,
I would say
okay.
His boxing is very good.
Okay.
However, he's not a professional boxer, so okay. I'm not knocking the Mike Tysons of the world and the Muhammad Ali's of the world. No, not knocking anyone on any level.
Okay.
But at this point, this is how green I was to the knowledge of boxing.
Got it.
The most famous boxer I ever knew was Rocky Balboa. And if you say that to anybody who knows boxing, they're like, yeah, he really wasn't a boxer.
That's like saying like, oh, Doogie Howser was
a doctor. I agree.
A fantastic doctor.
That just shows that shows my age bracket.
Mine too.
Anywho, so I'm 44. I was 36 when this happened to me. So when I was 36 and I found myself as a widow, a young widow, I had small children. My youngest was 2.5, he was three. And my oldest was 11. I was like, what am I going to do now? So when I decided that I was gonna take up boxing, I searched out for a boxing trainer and I found one. And I said to him, he was a professional fighter, I wanna learn how to box. And he was like, you're crazy. So
What were we just saying about when you tell a woman she's crazy?
Oh, when you tell a woman she's crazy, she takes that with her and she does it 10,000 times even better than she would have ever done.
Sometimes, right?
Oh no, we need to be told we're crazy a little bit because that gives us the power and the motivation to do it and do it so successfully that you leave that naysayer in the dust like, oh, she did it. Oh my gosh, this is
for
amazing.
For sure, opening a boudoir studio, people told me I was crazy.
Oh no, oh, but I think this is
You'll
fabulous.
Never make money doing that. You can't stay, you can't.
Oh, those people, what are they doing now? They're all, I'm just saying, you've done such a beautiful job here with your studio. It's absolutely incredible.
But you know what I'm saying? Like the whole like, you're crazy
yes.
thing is.
You should never put someone down.
Also, I think it's sort of a female-focused insult.
Completely, though.
If a man said, I'm going to open a boxing gym, would you say, you're crazy?
Never. No one
Maybe
would ever
not,
say that to
a right?
They would not say that to a man. Things to a man. But to a woman?
Yeah.
No, it's like all of a sudden they're focusing on all the negatives and all
no,
the things
that
can
go wrong.
If a man
said, I'm going to open a boudoir studio, they might get a little crazy.
But I think people would say, you're crazy, but you might be very successful at it. You never know. But however,
right. yeah.
when
Who
women
knows?
Do things,
yeah.
we get, okay, so.
We get pushback, don't we?
We definitely get pushback. And to be honest, though, I kind of like the pushback. Go ahead, bring it on. That's the way I look at it.
Give I like me, it, Angie.
I love it. You know, it's like there's got to be haters are going to hate, and there are going to be those haters out there, and that's all good. So doesn't bother me on any level.
Okay, Rebecca used to do sparring on Taekwondo.
Oh my God,
not
Rebecca!
Not the same as boxing, but.
No, but that's okay.
Yeah,
that's awesome sauce.
Pop on here if you have any other connection to the boxing world. We'd love to hear.
If you know anything about boxing, or if you have zero experience, but you would like to know more, raise your hand.
Yeah, we'd also like
give us a shout out. We would love to hear more because here's the thing. So this is what I did moving forward. So I trained, I fought a fight. I went through the whole entire experience with all the naysayers. I had zero support. So it was kind of like internally, I was a little bit crying, but externally I was like, I'm gonna do this, right? With that being said, I went through the whole entire journey from start to finish. And when I finished the journey, Liz, I felt this incredible, empowered, insanely emotional, amazing feeling that I cannot describe to you, but it was like out of this world, this feeling that I had inside of me. And I said to myself, okay, number one, I can't believe you did that. And number two, how can I give back to other women on planet Earth? I want to give women this feeling that I'm feeling, but how am I gonna give women a feeling, right? How do you box up a feeling and then package it up into a pretty little package and give it to them? How do you do that? So I spun my wheels and I spun my wheels, and I decided that the only way that I could actually give a feeling to another human being is by putting them through the same journey that I went through, but only better. Because here's the thing. I, throughout my journey, there was a lot of goods and there was a lot of not so goods in my journey. So I took all the goods.
And as all journeys are.
As all journeys are.
Right?
It's never a straight line from start to finish, correct?
So it wouldn't be a journey, it would be a sprint.
It would be a sprint, and it wouldn't be an adventurous, exciting, no. Along the way, you meet people, you meet the goods, you meet the bads, the not so goods. You meet the people who are supportive, and then you know what the thing is? You actually wind up meeting people that come out of nowhere, or they seemingly come out of nowhere, that are like your biggest cheerleaders.
Totally.
They're a complete, incredible support system, and you never saw them coming.
Ladies, if you have been on any kind of a journey, pipe up. I want to hear for you. Like, I think we've all been there, and felt like there was a lot of like this on our journey, but then also those people that showed up in our way that just really, like you said,
they pop out of nowhere.
They pop up out of nowhere, or even just they rise to the occasion. They were in your life, but they rise to the occasion to be a cheerleader for you on your journey. I want to hear about it. Tell us about it in the comments.
To be honest, you know, on that note, if I would have 10 years ago, if you would have said to me, listen, you're going to be in these shoes in 10 years, I would have said to you, oh, Liz, I know for sure who's going to be there for me. This person and this person and this person.
Oh.
And the crazy part about it is when push comes to shove and you're actually there, it is not the people that you think are going to be there for you. Has anybody ever experienced that? Because it's the people that you never saw coming that are there. They're there every day. They're your biggest cheerleaders. They're the ones who are helping you on a daily basis. The people that you assumed would be there, not so much.
Yeah, not always.
That's the sad part.
Us more specifics about what you're doing now.
Okay, so I wanted to give other women this feeling, right? Because I wanted to empower women if I was feeling a certain way, other women for sure are feeling a certain way. So I wanted to be able to give back. Okay, so this is what I did. I took all the good components of my journey, and then I took the not so good components of my journey and I tweaked them a little bit, because why does it always have to be the way it's always been? It doesn't have to be, right? I mean, all it takes is one crazy white girl to change up boxing a little bit, right? So I took the not so good part.
When you say that, do you mean that there weren't women in boxing, that there weren't white people in boxing?
There's women in boxing and there's white, there's women in boxing and there's white women.
Of course there are, but not dominated.
Not dominated obviously. On any level. And to be honest, when I wanted to go and learn how to box, it was there were no boxing gyms in the suburbs. And there were no boxing gyms in the suburbs, and it was predominantly non-white. it wasn't white female mothers who are raising six children, let's just put it that way. But okay. I wanted to change that up because why does it always have to be the way it's always been, right?
It does not.
So I decided to start training women in boxing, but not only that, I decided to hold an event that pretty much everyone thought I was crazy, including my trainer and everything, thought I was insane. I wanted to put on a boxing event for local women who had zero experience, who were not athletes, who were regular moms, raising babies, working jobs, multitasking, just like me in the suburbs. I mean, they don't necessarily have to be in the suburbs, but I live in the suburbs. So I was reaching out to the local women in my community, but that extends to the whole entire Chicagoland area. The thing is, I wanted regular, normal, non-athletes. I didn't want anybody to come from a boxing background at all. I want people to come that simply want to do something so incredibly empowering and so incredibly tough that they think never in their lifetime will they ever step into a ring, go through those ropes, and become a boxer. I wanted those women who were like, I can never in my lifetime do that. Okay, so never say never, right? So I'm like, these are the women that I want, the women who don't have any boxing experience, who don't know anything about boxing, who have never put on boxing gloves before, who don't even know who Muhammad Ali is. Those are the women that I want.
So you trained them.
Yes. So,
and okay, tell me a little bit. I mean, are they actually getting knocked out, getting unconscious? Like, tell me how this works.
Okay,
see boxing on TV and it looks pretty rough.
Boxing on TV is definitely, it's all about hitting and getting punched. But here's the thing. Okay, so when I first said this to my first group of ladies, I'm like, listen, no one's gonna get hurt. And they're like, how is that gonna happen, right?
Yeah.
This isn't about the knockout, right?
Okay.
This isn't about the hurting someone else. Not on any level, it's not. What it's about is the journey. And like I said to all of my boxers, and I've said this to their families and friends, it is about the journey getting to the night of the ring, to fight night. Once fight night arrives, you've won. It doesn't matter. It's you against you. You're in there with one other person, but truly it's you against you. And at that point, you have won. You have fought the fight. This is the finale. This is the celebration. That's what fight night is all about. Fight night is not about knocking somebody out. It's not about hurting someone else. Yes, they are throwing punches and they're very real punches, but they're not. At this point, I'm going to tell you, this is one.
So did any of them lose teeth?
Never. Nobody's ever lost teeth. Knock on wood. And I'm not putting it
like
in the
universe. I like my teeth.
I love my teeth too. Okay. I love my teeth. So
do you wear a mouth guard?
You definitely wear a mouth guard. Okay. Yes, you absolutely wear a mouth guard. You wear headgear. You have gloves on. So you're fully protected on every level. Not only that, I match up my boxers. I matched them up. This is not what happens in typical boxing, but this is how I did it because I wanted the women to feel safe in a boxing match, if that's possible. Safe, boxing, they don't really go hand in hand, but I wanted them to feel safe. I wanted them to become a team and I wanted them to become a unit and I wanted everyone. I bring a bunch of strangers together and they're all like, who's Liz and who is this and who are you? And so everyone's kind of nervous. It's kind of like being back in school. I've got small children and when they first day of school, you're like, I don't know her. So that nervous feeling, what I do is I see, okay, this is our group. These are the women that want to fight this year. And then we start training and then we match, we pair them up. So this person will fight together and this person will fight together. And then as we begin the journey, they will work every day, every time together. And they'll go round and round and round. We teach them how to box. We teach them how to, you know, do everything inside the ring. We teach them at the end of the...
And this is all at the boxing gym.
This is all at my gym. Okay. Yes, we do all of the training.
Where is the gym?
It's in Park Ridge, Illinois.
Okay.
So...
Illinois guys,
in case you don't know that. We've got Lake Michigan right down the street.
Okay, so walk me through at your gym. Let's say these ladies show up at 6 p.m. for a workout.
Yeah.
Walk me through a little bit what that looks like. Is it cardio first? Is it, do you just get right to boxing?
So we always warm up first. And it's always components of boxing. So for instance, our warm up, if it's raining and cold outside in Chicago, as it is sometimes, right? We start with jump roping. So that's how we start. And then it's like we will do some after the jump roping activity. If the weather is nice, we'll go for a little run outside. Don't get nervous. I'm not making people run. Everyone always gets nervous with the running component, but no, we will jump rope. It's always components of boxing. So we warm up with jump roping, and then we will start some drills. So we'll pair everybody up and we start with drills. Shadow boxing is where you're just throwing punches without, you're not hitting anything. You don't have gloves on necessarily. We will do drills like that. We'll pair each other up. We'll do drills with partners. And then at the very end is when we get into the actual sparring. And sparring is like where it's a mock fight. It's kind of like fighting, but you're not going as hard and not as aggressively. That's what sparring is, if you've ever heard the term. And that's how we typically end. But the thing is, with our training, everyone trains at our gym. And everyone trains together, and it's all people who are going to be in the event. You're not training with outsiders, you're training with only your partner and the other women that are going to be in the event, and everyone trains together because it's super, super important for me.
Yes. Here's what I feel, okay, I didn't mean to
interrupt. No, you didn't.
I feel like this is, okay.
Yeah.
This is what a woman brings to boxing.
Mm-hmm.
The idea that you can train together as a club,
exactly,
rather than to train as
opponents, correct,
and never meet each other.
Absolutely.
And I'm not saying a man couldn't do that, but that's what the brainchild of a woman plus boxing
truly
together.
It is. Yes,
do you know what I mean?
1,000%. Yes,
because women need community.
They do,
and they I don't want to generalize, but a lot of women really need community and really benefit from community.
Absolutely.
And if they find that while they're working out, that is more beneficial to them than to meet some stranger that in the ring that they remember. And I feel like that's what you're like secret sauce, what you brought to it.
It is.
Community.
But that is, you know what, thank you for saying that, because when I fought, I didn't know my opponent. That brings a super high level of scariness. You're like, oh my gosh.
They're like the enemy.
They're the enemy. And I didn't want that. I didn't even want to bring that negativity, that enemy feeling. I didn't want to bring that to the ring. That is not where I was going with this. I wanted the women not only to have a son.
Do you know Mary Beth Cook?
Of course I do. That's Mary Beth. So Mary Beth's husband is our referee.
Nice. Okay.
Her husband was a Golden Gloves champion. There you go. Nicest.
Hey, Mary Beth. So glad you're here. Thanks for tuning in.
Gorgeous girly. Thank you for being on.
And Dana says hit and hug.
So Dana is one of our trainers. She's one of our trainers. Yes, Dana's one of our trainers. So there we go. Dana fought in our first event.
Okay.
Okay. Mary Beth should fight this year. She should. Although she's the coach's wife. We say she's the coach's wife. So Dana fought in our first event and has now become one of our trainers this year.
She's amazing.
She's awesome sauce. And she has come. So, right, Dana? Like, it's an incredible experience that she stuck around, right?
Yeah. Are any other ladies on here that have done this? Chime in. We'd love to hear about your experience that know Angie, know the boxing world. Give us a shout out.
They know me pretty well.
Yeah.
So,
how many days a week do you train with this group?
So we really try to go by their schedule. However, we want them to come as often as they possibly can.
Yes.
The last season, we actually wound up training 7 days a week.
Holy
but
Lord.
Not Good every reason. Human was training 7 days a week.
But you were there.
We were there. We were open for business 7 days a week from the beginning of the day to the end of the day. Truly, we want to be there for our boxers because we want them to have the support and the love from us as well. We need to be there. We're the number one support
now,
system.
Do you participate in the fights?
I am the announcer.
Okay, you're the announcer.
Yeah, I'm the announcer. So okay. I'm the announcer and just the brainchild behind it. But truly, let me tell you, it takes a village.
Yes.
And like the Dana and Mary Beth are my villagers. We are a team.
I love it.
We are a team. Like we have the boxers and they are a team. And then we are a team that bring the whole thing together because I could never do this on my own. There is no one woman army. And I'm like the biggest person who preaches from my soapbox about that.
Yeah.
I truly wanted. So when I started my journey, I wanted to be part of a community, and I wasn't part of a community. And when my husband passed away, there was no support system surrounding me, and that was sad. I was sad because of it, but I wasn't going to let like life defeat me. Like I said, I wanted to build a village. I wanted to build a community of super supportive humans. And I don't just say women, I love men. We love men too. But the thing is, women have to support women.
And especially women in boxing have to find their own niche, I'm sure. Because
they do.
It's such a unique...
It's a completely unique sport.
I mean, it's not... It's just like a new niche for women.
It's new. It's different. It's scary. It's empowering. It's amazing. It's incredible. It's so many different adjectives, honestly. But the people that have come together because of my event, like Mary Beth and Dana... I am overwhelmed with love, truly, because these are the people that you never saw coming.
Yeah.
And you're just so very glad that they're there.
Don't you feel like the hardest things in life, like, this is what I actually, I mean, I know boudoir and boxing are the same thing. This
is what I like the boudoir.
This is what I also say about boudoir. Yes, it's scary.
Yes.
Yes, it is vulnerable, but that's why it's so awesome.
It is.
Right?
100%.
So, like, if it was just a really easy kind of dumb thing to do, it wouldn't be as valuable
it
or
wouldn't.
As meaningful. The
no.
gift you give to your partner is not as meaningful. The experience that you take away from it is not as meaningful.
Yes.
If it was just, like, an easy thing, then it would
everybody
not
be would be as doing it.
And it wouldn't...
It wouldn't be as impactful.
Right. So, that's why...
I agree.
And this is an important thing to learn in life. Mm-hmm. I think the two sides of the point, like, the empowering and the difficulty. Like, you can't have the beauty if you didn't go through the pain.
You have to go through the pain, unfortunately. I agree.
Yeah. And not that everything in life has to be painful, but, like, there is... joy on the other side of pain.
Oh, there truly is. But you know what? All of your hopes and dreams are on the other side of fear.
Yes.
You really truly have to face your fears, because all of the things that you've been wishing and hoping and wanting are always on the other side of fear. You have to go through it. As they say, you can't go around it, you can't go over it or under it. You have to go through it. And once you go through it and you realize, okay, I always say to myself, okay, what's worst case scenario here? If it's not death, I'm doing it, right? Because why not? Life is too short.
You haven't had any deaths in the boxing studio?
No, so. Knock on wood. That's like, knock on, no, there's no death. There's only happiness, truly.
Yeah.
At the end of each event, the women have been so happy and so filled with love and joy and a feeling, an emotional empowerment. It's just been a wonderful, not so much so that they want to come back. Like Dana, she hasn't left us, right?
Yeah.
And there are so many other ladies. If nobody ever leaves and says, ah, see ya. No, that's not what we've experienced at all. We've experienced like, okay, how can I help next year? And what can I do? And that's what I love so much. We have built a community. And like I said, I was the brainchild, but I opened the doors, and when you open the doors, it invites all the right humans into your world. And I didn't know Dana and Mary Beth, and we didn't know each other before this, and now I couldn't live without them. I need them. Truly.
Okay, Dana says, sometimes overcoming something that wasn't on your radar helps you gain the confidence to check off your bucket list.
That's exactly right, right? Absolutely. Something that wasn't on your radar that you didn't know that you ever even wanted to do. And Dana was actually super nervous when she first came in. I can still see her when she first came in. The very first day, she was really, really nervous. And then Dana was actually the only human who showed up on day one for training. No one showed up except for Dana. And she was like,
private lesson.
Oh my God, that's exactly. She was like, oh my God, why is it just me? But you know what? She leaps and bounds, and she's an amazing boxer now. She's probably way better than me now. It's like, and it's not about being better than each other. It's about helping each other get better in their own skin and feeling wonderful in their body with their skills and all that goes along with that. But like truly, the community is unmatched. It's unparalleled to any other community that you can possibly think of. And boxing brought us together. Who knew?
Tell us a couple specifics. When is your 2020 event? What's the name of your gym? How can people find out more?
Okay, it's called Angie's Boxing Garage. We have a Facebook and an Instagram, or you can message me directly, Angie's Boxing Garage. And the event this year is on April 17th. It's a Friday night. It's in Des Plaines at a restaurant called Cafe Le Cave. And so April 17th, 7 p.m., Cafe Le Cave in Des Plaines. If you would like to know more, send me a message, Angie's Boxing Garage, or you can just message me. I'm Angie Bellino May. on Facebook.
Let's say someone totally wants to join. It's too late to get in.
It's absolutely not too late to get in because, as a matter of fact, we're having an info session this Sunday at 11 a.m. at the garage. So if there's any woman out there interested, and there is no pressure, I promise you, there will be no pressure on my end. But if there's anyone out there who is interested in learning a little bit more, you are welcome to come over to the garage this Sunday at 11 a.m. And you're welcome to bring anyone you would like, your husband, your children, your mom, anyone, your sister, bring the whole family. The more the merrier at my house. Like I said, I have 6 kids. The more the merrier.
So, because I imagine a lot of women, they're curious, but they need to come check it out.
Completely. Yeah. Absolutely.
So this Sunday at Angie's Boston.
This Sunday, it'll give you a slice of what you'll actually be in the garage. So you'll be in the place where we're training, and you'll be meeting all of us. You'll be meeting me. Not only that, you'll be meeting Dana and Mary Beth. They will be there as well.
Yes,
right?
Awesome.
The whole boxing family will be there. Plus, there will be other women who have fought in the past events there to answer any and every question. Because, you know, you get one side of it from me, and then you're going to get all the ins and outs from the people who have actually gone through the journey themselves. So, 11 a.m. this Sunday at the garage. Message me, and I'll give you the address. Thank you so much for doing this interview with me
today. We're gonna get on here and put some of the info in the comments.
Yes,
too,
absolutely.
Because we want people to find it.
I love it.
And
Liz, you should box.
I should box.
Liz should box, right? I think Liz should box, right? Liz should box, and then we'll all do a boudoir shoot. I think that's what we should do.
So Angie, I have this fantastic idea of you.
Yes.
With some boxing gloves.
Oh.
In a boudoir shoot.
Oh my goodness.
And if you were ever for, I'm gonna give Angie $100 off.
Oh my goodness, look at that. Okay, she's gonna be our next boxer. Liz, okay.
So if you decide that boudoir is in your future,
okay,
I think we could do a boxing themed boudoir shoot.
I think
no joke.
We could do a boxing themed boudoir shoot, and you would be a fantastic boxer as well.
Well,
don't you agree?
That.
I think so. So I think this is a win-win situation.
I mean, I will.
We've made a connection right
here. You guys know that I made workout goals for 2020.
Okay, this is it. Oh, you did do the workout goals. I saw your workout. Yes, I love this.
You need help.
No, you're amazing. Oh, see, right? Mary Beth.
I need more of a community, maybe.
Oh, no, you need our community. That's it. See, we found each other for a reason. I love this. Okay, I will take you up on this.
Yes. Yeah, so
and you will think about boxing in our event.
I will think about boxing.
Thank you.
I saw my husband about it last night.
Yeah, see, I'm telling you. 11 o'clock Sunday. 11
really
o'clock
good
Sunday. Right.
My husband gets up and works out all the time.
Because men are...
Yeah, it works out for fun.
Right, but you know what? That's what they do. Men work out for fun, and you know what? And because we're taking care of our babies and our business, and but you know what? You can do it. You can do anything you set your mind to.
No, that is true. It's a mindset.
It's a mindset. Anything you set your mind to, nothing is impossible, right? Nothing is impossible, as Audrey Hepburn said.
You know what? It is true.
It's true.
It is true.
It is. And when you put your mind to it, it's all literally about the mindset. Because when people tell me, I just don't have the time, I'm like, no, you're just not making the time.
That is true.
Where there's a will, there's a way.
You make time for what you want to have in
your life. Definitely do. So I personally think, and I think all of you guys should help support Liz, she could be our next boxer. Don't you think?
Can you imagine?
Yes, I could, actually. I think
it would be
amazing. Oh, thanks so much, Liz, for having me. I really appreciate it today.
Thank you. Okay, so guys, we're going to put some information and links. Send a DM to Angie this Sunday at 11. Let us know what you think. And if Angie comes in for boudoir shoot and brings her boxing gloves,
I'm going to bring my whole boxing team. We're all coming,
girls. We're going to bring the whole team.
I love that. Thank you so much, you guys.
All right, thanks. This was
so
fun.
Have the most fabulous Friday.
We'll see you soon, okay?
Thank you.